Okay, bullets and numbering is yet another funny thing, and it is a common thing with word processing. Say when you are using Microsoft Word, let's say you want to apply bullets somewhere here. So you go to home and you click on this bullet, or you first need to specify what kind of bullet format you want to use. If you want to use this, you can choose this. So if you want this or this, let me pick this and type here, say tables. When you press enter, queries, press enter, modules, reports. Okay, when you press enter, you go ahead and add forms. Once you are done with your bulleted list, you simply need to press enter twice and you are done. But you can also be required at a certain point to change these bullets into numbers. So you highlight and you come to this section and you choose this particular numbering format that you please. So you can have this, you can have that, you can have this, you can have that. The choice is here. So when you click this, that is what happens. Now, with this document, we have 6 pages. So when we scroll, we actually see that there are quite a number of pages here, and we have 6 pages. This is now page 6 of 6. I'm going to show you how to apply headers. To apply headers, you need to go to Insert, and then you come to Header. Then you choose the style. Do you want it to be like this? Do you want it to be like this? There are still more. Okay, if we pick something like this, this is how this text is going to be like. My name. Assuming you have been asked to put your name. Once you're done, you close header and footer. There is something unique about this header style. It comes with the border. Now, let's pick another header style and we see what happens. You see, this has got a header style. So let's pick, let me pick something, grid. So grid, here we are typing my document. Okay, like that. When we close header, this document, my document, will appear in all the pages. It will appear in all the pages, as you see. So let's see what happens when you want to insert a footer. If you want to insert a footer, simple, come to footer, and then you pick a style. Is it this? You click. Or look for yet another. A footer can be a page number or other text. So let me see which footer do I put. Let me pick this one. So this is going to be my country, Uganda. Then close header and footer. So when you scroll, you'll actually see that this footer is appearing in all the pages. But I have had requests from most learners on how to customize the header and how to customize the footer. You may want to have a different footer or header on the first page and say a different header or footer on event pages. So what do? You go back to Insert. If you are going to customize the header, you click header. Now I'm picking this first one, which is blank text. Okay? Now in this case, it is giving us room that different on first page. So I will click here. Different on odd and even pages. I will also click here. So it removes this. So it is now giving me an opportunity to go up to first page. So I can type here, Papa, okay, then scroll, move down. You'll actually see that first on the event page, when I type here, Mama, and I scroll, that is going to be not the same as that on the page 3, as you can see. So I'm going to put this as daughter. So when we have a quick look, you will see that first page is saying Papa. Second page, this one here, which is an event page, as you are seeing from down here, it is saying Mama. When we move to the third page, it is now saying the header is daughter. Then as we scroll again, you will see that this one is saying Mama. Okay? That is event page. Daughter on old page. Mama on event page. That is how you customize a header. You do the same when you want to customize a footer. I will exit this. You can also be asked to insert the copyright symbol. I said you can also be required to insert a copyright symbol like this. To insert a copyright symbol, what you need to do is to press Ctrl Alt plus C. If you are to insert a trademark symbol, Ctrl Alt plus T. If you are to insert the registered trademark, you need to press Ctrl Alt plus R. I will repeat. To insert the copyright symbol, Ctrl Alt C. You're right. Trademark, Ctrl Alt T. Registered, Ctrl Alt R. Very good to know. At some point, you can also be required to insert, say, text box or a shape of some sort. So you go to insert and pick a shape. Here I'm picking, say, this text box, and I will click here. Okay? And you can type something there. Here, when you click inside the box, you'll be presented with this drawings tab, from where you can be able to change the shape, color, the outer color here. Okay? So you can as well click here and change the shape outline color by picking, say, this red. You can also come here to shape outline, come to weight, and you can pick something like that. See that? And you can be required to fill it with a specific color. Let's say blue. You can also add other effects, as you can see. You are seeing reflection, soft edges, yeah, glow, reveal. That is what you can again add here. So good. Line color, fill color. You can be asked to change the line color, fill color. You can pick a line like this, draw, and you want to change the thickness while it is still highlighted. Remember, you come here, come to this, you click on it. Yeah, that is how you can go about it. Sometimes, like with this document has only one page, as you can see from down here. Even when we scroll, it has only one page. So your interest may be, and this one is in portrait, as you can see. It is in portrait. You can change the page layout of a particular page, like this one which has only one document. You click on orientation and choose portrait. And now it has changed the page orientation. Because we have changed the page orientation, the text that was fitting in portrait has been extended to the following page. Let's switch this to portrait. And now, if you are interested, because this first page is in portrait, if your interest is to make the second page to appear in landscape, to make it much easy, you have to go to, you make sure you are here, then you click breaks, then you say next page. You click. Once you do that, it creates for you a new page. From where then you can be able to tell Microsoft Word to change this particular page 2 into landscape. How? Click orientation. Then you say landscape. So you will notice that this page 1 is in portrait, page 2 is in landscape. If you put some text, copied this text and pasted it here, and now you are also interested in making the following page, page 3, in portrait, you want to go back to portrait, you again need to come to, while you are here, you need to come to breaks, then you say next page, it breaks you like that, then while the cursor is here, come to orientation and you choose portrait. That is how you can be able to manipulate your section breaks and the page orientation. It is good to know how to do this. The other thing is to do with page numbers. Now, this document has got 3 pages and would like to paginate it. So we'll go to insert, choose page number. When we say page number and choose top of page, top of page allows us to put the page number in the header section, while bottom of page allows us to put it in the footer section. So we shall put it on the bottom section, okay? Put it on the bottom by clicking this. Let me see if I can pick this one. Yes, let me put it at the center. So that has included a page number here, so you can see. So when we scroll, you will see that this is page 2. We scroll, that is page 1. It is also important to know that you can change the style here. You can change the style. You can change the style of the pages from 1 to maybe something else. So let's close this first. Let's go to let's go to insert, page number, format page numbers. So click here, format page number, and choose the format style and pick if it is this or this or even this. We shall choose this. Then you say OK. Now when you say OK like that, when you have already inserted the page numbers, these ones will remain. So for you to affect this style, you need to go back to page number, come to bottom of page, then you still have to click on this style. And that's when it will affect it. I know you have been wondering how to do that, but that is the simplest way to do it. Okay? So you can also be required to change something to superscript or subscript. So this in red, for example, you highlight it, Control Shift plus equals, that takes it to the superscript section. Highlight, Control Shift equals. Alternatively, you could highlight it like that, go to home, then you pick on this option, highlight it, pick on this option, as you are seeing. While to put this in subscript, it is Control plus equals. Control plus equals, or you can go a long way by clicking this, highlight, click that, highlight, click that. Good. And you can also be required to insert a watermark. You go to page layout, then you come to where it says watermark. If you are supposed to insert confidential, this is what you will click, or this option, or this. Otherwise, if you are supposed to put a customized watermark, then you have to click on custom watermark. When you click on custom watermark, right now it is saying no watermark. Right now it is saying no watermark. So I will have to click on this radio button saying text watermark. Now, where there is a SAP, I will clear that, highlight and delete, then say education. Say education. If you are supposed to use a specific font, you will pick a font from here. That font. Let's say you are supposed to use Gabriola. Okay? The size, if you are also required to put a specific size, you can specific size, you pick it from here, 54. Specific color, you pick it from here, if it is red. Are you going to put it diagonally? Do you want it to be semi-transparent? Then you check this box, you make sure it is checked. Then you say, okay. So, the watermark is inside here, saying education, as you can see.